Hi, I'm Alex Hoffman Bisson. I'm from Eureka, South Dakota, and graduated from SDSU in 2011. I won 53 events and set 9 school records here as a swimmer. I'm excited to host your 1 of 10. This is a decade of excellence.
The Jackrabbits score on Derek Domino's interception.
And what Young is doing to TCU is getting old.
Home run, at number 15 on the season.
2009-2010. By now, we had been in the Summit League and the Missouri Valley Football Conference for 2 seasons. We were starting to get pretty good at this whole Division I thing. Our football program had only made the postseason once in Division II. It equaled that in its second year of eligibility in D1. Behind one of the nation's stingiest defenses, we won 7 of our first 8 and made the 16-team FCS playoffs. Danny Batten led the defense. Before he went on to the NFL, he was an All-American defensive end, sacking the quarterback 9 times that year. Running back Kyle Minette rushed for 100 yards 7 different times. He was not only an All-American on the field, but also academically. Safety Conrad Kierstead was also an academic All-American, earning his degree in agricultural business. Lastly, Coach John Stiglmeyer was a National Coach of the Year finalist. Cross country became the first men's program to win a Summit League championship. Rod DeHaven won Coach of the Year honors, as 4 of the top 12 finishers at the conference meet were Jacks. Despite only having 2 seniors, the soccer team won the Summit League's regular season title. In the winter, it was women's basketball that shined brightest. They won 14 of their final 17. In the Summit League tournament, they avenged 2 regular season losses to Oral Roberts in a memorable 79-75 overtime victory. Tyler Sorensen became our first Division I wrestler to win at the NCAA championships. In fact, he earned 2 wins in Omaha. 1985 marked the last year a Jackrabbit won a conference title in swimming. That is, until Katie Boodall. She won the 100 and 200 breaststroke at the Summit League Conference Championship. She won 42 events and set 4 school records during her time at State. Jared Vlaschin swept the indoor and outdoor long jump events, leading the track and field teams to 9 Summit League titles. In the classroom, distance runner Amanda Froling earned academic All-American, majoring in biology and pre-physical therapy. Baseball used a record-breaking offense to win the Summit League's regular season title. That earned Richie Price the conference's Coach of the Year. Outfielder John Lee was an academic All-American. His 3.902 GPA in chemistry also earned him the league's Men's Scholar Athlete Award. And closer Trevor Vermillion won 9 games and saved 10 more with a minuscule 1.45 earned run average to receive All-American recognition. Also, pitcher Blake Treinen, a future major leaguer, was drafted in the 23rd round by the Florida Marlins. However, he would return to SDSU in lieu of signing. It was an impressive year, setting the tone for what would become a decade of excellence. Men's cross country, soccer, women's basketball, and baseball all brought home conference titles. We had 3 All-Americans, 4 academic All-Americans, 223 academic All-Conference picks, 76 All-League selections, and a cumulative GPA of 3.068. Lastly, the fall of 2009 saw the Dykehouse Student Athlete Center open, housing coaching offices for football and track and field, plus a weight room, athletic training area, and academic center. It was the first of many significant facility upgrades over the last 10 years. I had some of the best times here in this pool and on this campus, but we are just getting started with our look back at the last 10 years. Stay tuned for another edition of A Decade of Excellence. And remember, go big, go blue, go Jacks.